It seems that every year people start saying things like, oh, this is the best year in gaming, or the best year in a long, long time, or this was the worst year in gaming. But what actually was the best year in gaming? Have you ever thought about that? Well, that's what we're going to go over. We're going to look at some of the best years for the gaming industry ever since its inception. So be sure to let me know what year was your favorite in gaming, and also let me know if you want me to do the opposite side of this list and do the worst years of gaming. If you do, drop a like, let me know in the comment section, and here we go. 1991. Kicking off our list is the first year that companies really started catching up to Nintendo. Following the big video game crash of the early 1980s, Nintendo pretty much single-handedly picked up the pieces thanks to things like the NES and the Super NES, as well as games like Super Mario Bros. 1 through 3, Metroid, and The Legend of Zelda. But it wasn't until the early 90s that other companies really started to catch on and catch up, and in 1991, the industry truly made its full recovery. In 91, Sega released the original Sonic the Hedgehog, MicroProse released the first Civilization game, LucasArts released Monkey Island 2, Capcom released the legendary Street Fighter 2, and Nintendo continued their hot streak with the release of Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past, one of my favorite games of all time. 1991 was a huge year for gaming, and it really started to get companies other than Nintendo into the mainstream mix. 2011. The seventh console generation was a good one. It helped push the industry forward in huge ways, and we got our hands on some incredible games that helped shape the market as a whole. Looking back on it, 2011 was arguably the year that really popularized mainstream open-world games. It saw the release of excellent, successful open-world games like Saints Row the Third, Batman Arkham City, and L.A. Noire, as well as RPGs like Dark Souls and the now legendary Skyrim. It also contained the releases of other critically acclaimed games like Portal 2, Dead Space 2, and yes, Minecraft, one of the most successful games in history. But if you think 2011 was a stacked year for gaming, just wait until we get going, because we're still at we're only at number 9. 1993. Like I said before, that 1991 was the year that got the other companies really involved with the industry. But a couple years later, those companies really started to stretch their legs and show that they had what it takes to keep up. In 93, LucasArts released two classics, Day of the Tentacle and Sam & Max Hit the Road, which continued to popularize the adventure game genre. Midway also released two arcade classics in the form of NBA Jam and Mortal Kombat 2. Of course, Nintendo was there, keeping fans happy with Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, but perhaps the biggest game to come out in 1993, can you guess? I'll give you a second. It was Doom, the game that pretty much single-handedly popularized first-person shooters and made huge technical leaps for the gaming industry as a whole. 2004. Now, it was a year that the big HD games started to show their faces. And sure, not all of them look great today, but for 2004 standards, it was a year of technical innovation, both graphically and in terms of game design and world building. We saw the release of Metal Gear Solid 3 and Half-Life 2, two of the best video game stories ever told to this day. We also got our hands on games like Doom 3, Fable, GTA San Andreas, Rome Total War, and Chronicles of Riddick: Escape from Butcher Bay, one of the best movie games ever made. But perhaps the biggest release of 2004 was the World of Warcraft, Blizzard's heavy hitter that is still going strong to this day, and it remains the biggest MMO in the world year after year. I mean, that's a long time at the top. 2000, the turn of the century. Now, 2000 was a huge year for PC gaming in particular, as developers started to get very, very creative with what could be done with their hardware. In 2000, Valve released the original Counter-Strike, Blizzard released Diablo 2, EA released The Sims, Black Isle Studios released Baldur's Gate 2, and Eidos gave us Thief 2, one of the best stealth games of all time. But that's not to say PC had all the goodies of that year. We also saw the release of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2, one of the best-reviewed games ever released, and The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask, arguably the best game in the entire Legend of Zelda series. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. 2005. This was the last year for the sixth generation of consoles. That would be the PS2, the Xbox, and the GameCube. And normally, when a console generation is about to end, developers kind of just coast their way through it and they save their heavy hitters for the new consoles. But 2005 completely turned that tradition on its head, and they gave us a whole new slew of amazing games. In 2005, Capcom released Devil May Cry 3 and Resident Evil 4. Sony released Shadow of the Colossus and the original God of War. Ubisoft put out Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, and Red Octane threw their hat into the ring with the first ever Guitar Hero. It was also a great year to be a Star Wars fan, as we got both Battlefront 2, the best Battlefront, and Republic Commando, two of the best Star Wars games ever made. And as a little bonus, we got our first taste of LEGO Star Wars and, surprisingly, the good Revenge of the Sith movie tie-in game for the PS2 and the Xbox. Other notable releases for that year: Call of Duty 2, Prince of Persia, The Two Thrones, and Psychonauts. And keep in mind, we're still only at number 5, but looking at 2005, it was a stacked year. 2010, it was, well, we said 2005 was loaded. I mean, 2010 was on another level, okay? In fact, I think it's the most loaded year we've had in a long time. As I'm sure you guys know, it usually takes a few years for the developers to really get the hang of the new console generations. Well, the Xbox 360 and the PS3 launched in late 2005 and 2006, respectively. And by the time 2010 rolled around, the devs knew exactly what they were doing. We saw the release of Mass Effect 2, Red Dead Redemption, Call of Duty Black Ops, Fallout New Vegas, Dead Rising 2, Bioshock 2, and Just Cause 2. But it wasn't just a big AAA studios type thing. They weren't the only ones showing their stuff off. It was actually a really big year for indie games as well, thanks to the releases of Amnesia the Dark Descent, Super Meat Boy, and three of the best indie games of all time, if you ask me. And of course, just to top off the year, there's Nintendo throwing in Super Mario Galaxy 2 and Blizzard throwing in StarCraft 2. Now that I think about it, 2010 was a good year for gaming. 2007. Okay, I know I just said it usually takes developers a few years to get used to the new console gens, but I'm going to take that back for this one, because 2007 was arguably even more loaded than 2010, and I think most of us can agree that the PS3 and the 360 kind of had a slow first year on the market, but 2011 came around and they took off. We saw the release of Bioshock, Call of Duty 4, Halo 3, Crackdown, and Super Mario Galaxy, all of which were system sellers. Valve also had a big year that year. They released Portal, Team Fortress 2, and Half-Life 2 Episode 2. PC gamers also got a good 2007 thanks to the release of Crysis and The Witcher, and even the freaking PlayStation 2 had a good year thanks to the release of the God of War 2 game. Other notable releases were Unreal Tournament 3, Mass Effect, Rock Band, Guitar Hero 3, Manhunt 2, and of course, LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. 2001. Now, you hear a lot about the best genre game ever made, you know, best shooter ever made, best strategy ever made, so on and so forth. But looking back on it, I think 2001 actually had a ton of those games in its lineup altogether. We saw the release of Final Fantasy X, one of the best RPGs of all time. Silent Hill 2, arguably the best horror game ever made. Super Smash Bros. Melee, obviously one of the best fighter games ever made. Metal Gear Solid 2, one of the best stealth games ever made. And Halo Combat Evolved, one of the best FPS games ever made. There were a ton of best ever games in 2001. It would be the year of best ever. And the list of great games, it didn't stop. We also saw Devil May Cry, Max Payne, Animal Crossing, Conker's Bad Fur Day, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 3, Sonic's Adventure 2, Luigi's Mansion, Return to Castle Wolfenstein, Civilization 3, and freaking RuneScape. And finally, the best year of gaming. Are you ready for this? 1996. The most influential year of gaming, if you ask me. Okay, this is really when people started innovating with the hardware and started making games more about the experience rather than just the high score. In 96, Nintendo not only revolutionized 3D gaming with the release of Super Mario 64, but they also gave birth to one of the biggest franchises ever with the release of Pokemon Red and Blue, as well as a little oddball thrown in with the Super Mario RPG for the Super NES. GT Interactive helped push the FPS genre forward with the release of Duke Nukem 3D and Quake. And then Capcom virtually invented the survival horror genre with the release of Resident Evil. And they even continued the very popular Mega Man series with the release of Mega Man X3. They weren't the only ones, though. Blizzard made huge leaps for PC gaming with the release of Diablo. Sony threw their hat into the 3D platforming ring with Crash Bandicoot. And the list goes on and on. Rareware continued to be one of the most consistent developers around the release of Donkey Kong Country 3. And Eidos, well, they created a gaming icon with the release of Tomb Raider. Namco released Tekken 2 one of the most beloved fighting games of all time, ID Software came back with Final Doom and a fan favorite standalone expansion for Doom 2. 1996 was filled to the brim with innovation in the gaming industry and the creation of franchises that continue to this very day. And if you ask me, 96 was the best year in gaming history thanks to the quality games and the pushing of technology and the industry itself into what we have today. And there you have it. That is a trip down, to me, the best years in gaming. If you guys would like to see the worst years in gaming, let me know in the comment section. Make sure you guys take a second, turn on those post notifications, ring that little bell so you always get notified when a video goes live, and I'll see you soon.